Grasp is about the science of learning. In the era of online education, what does it mean to form a memory? Is testing good? Is it bad? How people actually learn? These are very fundamental questions. I mean, the human being is a learning animal. And I have this great partnership with Luke Yoquinto, who is my co-author. He was able to help me craft the narrative. And it became clear that there was a really beautiful arc here that needed to be explained. A lot of the things that we take for granted are not necessarily based on any particular science. In a lot of education institutions, a classroom is basically you go in, you sit down, and you listen to the professor lecture, and a lot of it is about memorization and having students cram for an exam, which they sort of forget right after the exam. In fact, the science shows that. There's another fallacy in education is somehow a student's ability is something very innate. And we see the education process as a way to find the God-given talents of a few students and to winnow. This model is antithetical to what we should be doing, which is every student is good enough, let's make them a success. I went to school in India, I got into the Indian Institute of Technology. Now at IIT, I personally felt I lost purpose, and I sort of wandered. I went to work in industry, and that really reanimated because suddenly I found purpose. So when I went to grad school, I realized that purpose creates engagement. It became clear to me that we need to rethink education because what we need to do is create empowered, capable, self-efficacious individuals who can take charge of their life. And you cannot do that if you don't engage with them. The office that I lead, MIT's Open Learning, we want to make knowledge a resource that almost anyone can access through OpenCourseWare, through MITx, through the MicroMasters, and through other programs. And we had to be very sure that we were doing it right. The things that we do better online, we should do online. And the things we can do online, we should be doing in the classroom. At some level, what the pandemic has done is it puts a spotlight on what makes in-person worth it. I hope the book will help clarify that the classroom time cannot be squandered away on things you could do online. If you take all the other challenges humanity faces, climate change, political strife, perhaps the next pandemic, the underpinning of that is education.